Evening, everyone. I want to sort of, I would say exactly what I've heard quite a few times here today, that the Muslim community is being unfairly judged, by the actions of very, very, very few. I also would say, which is true, that no other community gets judged in the same way. Like, you know, if I was running down the street and I stabbed someone, I said, the Lord Jesus Christ is my saviour. Nobody would get the Archbishop of Canterbury up to ask him what he thought I was doing. I think everybody would just look at me and go, what is wrong with her? I am also concerned about the rhetoric which is used by mainstream politicians. Not only did Tony Blair say there's a problem within the Muslim community, although we all agreed on just the cheek of the man, to be quite frank, after everything that he's done, I think his problem with Muslims is that he's upset that there are some still left after his actions. And also David Cameron joined in as well. After Breivik murdered 77 people, he joined in and said, well, perhaps he has a point. Perhaps multiculturalism doesn't work. I would say to David Cameron, just because you don't have any black friends, it doesn't mean multiculturalism. I don't know. I feel this. What's happened in the last few, in the last couple of weeks, I found it extremely disturbing. I would say that I am not to downplay the threat of the EDL and the BNP too much, because they are the ones out there sort of lobbing bricks at people, desecrating mosques, insulting people. So I think to downplay that would be foolish. Also, I would say that there is also a problem, not only just with right-wing people, there's a problem on the left as well. And people have quoted Martin Luther King quite a few times today, and I would quote him again, where he wrote the letters from his Birmingham jail cell, where he said, beware of the moderate. Now, I have heard quite a few people who are supposedly anti-EDL talking about certain things and telling us the best way to fight them. There's some articles going around that we mustn't tease the EDL about their spelling because it's classist, which again is implying that all working class people are stupid, they can't spell, and that they're racist, which actually isn't the case at all. But these are not coming from the right, these things are coming from the left. I don't like the way that the narrative is being dictated to the actual mainstream victims of the EDL, which are people of colour, let's face it, because they can't seem to accept that there are white Muslims. We all know the white Muslims, but for the most part, they are looking at Muslims as people of colour. And I don't want the narrative dictated to us on how we're going to react and how we aren't going to react, because if you're just concerned about the EDL being teased about their accent and the way that they spell, then you're really taking out an experience of a whole set of people, because we have grown up listening to people like the EDL and BNP laughing at the way that we speak and laughing at our accents and saying how we need to learn English when half of them can't speak it themselves. That's where that comes from. It's not anything to do with class. Also, I don't know, I just found like what's happened over the last few days absolutely, absolutely shocking. And I have been asked, because obviously I perform and stuff, and I've had people tweeting at me, asking me the most ridiculous questions. I mean, I think it's easy, the natural thing for people to do is they turn around and they start to have to prove how English we are. Well, I was born here, I'm from here, my kids are from here, they grew up here, I love this country, I live here. Even if I don't love this country, I have the right not to like it. If I don't like it. About this is, I can say whatever I want to. When something like this happens, I don't have to go out, and this guy was saying to me, well, prove your English. I was like, I'm an alcoholic, what's more? I don't know. All I want to say is thank you very much to everybody that came out and supported the demonstration on Saturday. Because we were really badly outnumbered the Monday before. And we all have different ways and different approaches to doing things, and I think that they should be respected, and nobody should be dictating to anybody else as to how we are going to fight this. We can all sit and we can talk together. And I think the other thing that's coming up a lot is, well, you know, if you make tea, or if you hug Tommy Robinson, or if he hugs you, you know, please. What people need to understand is this. When someone goes to a certain point, it's up to them to change. It's not up to us to hug you or make you tea. You are the one with the problem, not us. And the amount of cuts you get, I can make you cups of tea all day long, I can hug you all day long, but if you're in the BNP, it makes no difference. Your problem is that with me is that I am black. That's not going to change. So you have to change your attitude. And thank you very much.